The Innovation for Defense Excellence and Security Program recently issued a challenge calling for proposals to retrofit existing older buildings across national defense and the Canadian Forces to lessen the organization's impact on the environment. Matt Striegler, Senior Advisor to the Directorate of Portfolio Innovation, Infrastructure, and Environment Group, joins us today to tell us more about this important challenge and what it means for defense, Canada, energy consumption, and the reduction of global carbon footprints. So thanks for joining us today, Matt. To kick us off, can you maybe talk to us a little bit about what the key drivers were behind launching this challenge?
So the key drivers are fairly simple to explain. All you have to do is think about the news that's been in the news cycle for the last couple of years, just increasing every year. You can think about what's going on in BC right now, in Northern Ontario, the floods in Germany, fires in Australia, the Fort Mac fire. All of this is as a result of the climate warming and the climate change, which is a crisis. And that's as a result of our GHG emissions. So that's the driver, is that we have to reduce that carbon footprint. And we've been mandated by the government to reduce that footprint. And it's going to be at a much more accelerated pace. D&D, as a federal department, we're responsible for about, right now, a little less than 50% of the government's operating emissions. And of that 50%, 90% comes from our building portfolio. We have a massive portfolio across Canada.
Understood. So the primary focus is to find an alternative heating mechanism that is going to reduce the carbon footprint for our facilities. And you mentioned the sheer number of facilities that is operated by D&D CAF across the country. Are there any other potential positive benefits that we could hope to yield from this challenge in our fight against climate change?
Yeah, one of the biggest benefits is of course cost savings. I mean, right now, if we were the only potential way to meet that challenge right now is to transform our entire portfolio into net zero. That's literally billions of dollars. Like it would be massive. We have, aside from the housing stock, the operational stock, the warehouses, the messes, the barracks, the hangars, that's 10,000 buildings. And there, a lot of those buildings are massive buildings that take 60, 70, 80 million to upgrade. So doing that, having to do that would be just an enormous burden of cost on the department that we wouldn't normally have to do that. Those buildings would still be there and operational for 40 years. So if we can find a way to transform heating those buildings with a low carbon system without having to reskin the building, do major upgrades and introduce new mechanical equipment inside the building, new roofs, you know, those major insulation upgrades that are required, we're going to have that huge cost burden removed from us in the future.
And thank you for being with us today, and good luck with the challenge.
It was a pleasure. Thank you.